Welcome back. We are doing our December videos, and I haven't got them all down yet, so I did one already for the 1st of December. Welcome. And that was Thursday. This last Thursday. I'm not sure what I have on Friday, which is the 2nd, December 2nd. I don't think I have one yet. I'm not sure. But, in other words, this will probably be Fridays. So, Thursday, December 1st is the welcome. And I introduced you to this box is the 1st. And so, Friday, I'm not sure what's in there. If I'm going to put this on Friday and do a different one for, I don't know. We'll see. But, here is, I put it all on the inside. Put it all together, and it's a mess. You can see what I started to do these on the outside, and I'm like, oh, I want it to be smooth on the outside. So I took it off, redid it. So here's the little box, and I've already pre-cut all my sides now. So all I have to do is just put it on. So this is what I got for the back of the front one. I'll probably have to, I might have to cut it down just a smidge because it changed how it goes in, and we want it to just fit. There we go. Perfect. See? Right there. So we're going to be decorating this box, so if you want to do that, keep watching. And if you want to go see this one, I'm going to link it either in an iCard or down below of the lady that I saw this from. So you can do it if you want to. Follow it along, whatever, follow her thing. Now I am going to use black because red's going to look funny because it's a bright red. So before I put these in, and before I hook them in, I'm going to, but these ones really don't matter on the inside. But see, it kind of curled this corner a little bit. I might snip that corner a little bit. And I do everything by kind of trial and error. I did measure this, and I don't remember where I saw the measurements for it. But I have them written down on the sides. This one isn't. This one's not written down, but it's written down right here, and you just do the reverse. And the back is on the inside. I didn't do that one right. So, and then the bottom. I didn't cut out the bottom. I still have to cut out the bottom to put on the bottom. I don't know if I'm going to. You know, I don't know. If I decide to, it's not a big deal. I can just put it in there. So here's the sides. So which one is squished? This one. So I can put this in, and it's gonna hide all of my cuts. See, I think I'm gonna have to cut this one again. And I'm gonna kind of round it a little bit on the bottom. So it's gonna be a little bit different because it's getting smooshed. There, that's better. Can you see it all right? I don't know if you can see it all right. There's kind of a little bit of, there we go. So I think I'm going to use score tape to hook these on. It's probably going to be easier that way. I'll put a little bit. I don't know if I can find my glue. Here's my glue. I'll have to see if it's stuck. Add some glue to it too. I may have to get a new bottle. No, it works. Okay, so we'll do that too. But before that, this is the paper pads I am using. These are what I have left over. And that's what I picked to use for this. And I picked out each of the tags. I think there's 25. So you can either do, because these are front and back, these only, and cut them to the size of the each one. Or, see, I'm torn because I don't, if I do it like this and cut them to size, and I can leave the top like this, you know, cut off the hole, obviously, and I can make that little design and use my scissors that I have if I want. But then this one isn't decorated, the back side. So I haven't figured that out yet. I'm still thinking about it. So this is the first deal. So this is the one we're gonna do. So what I'm gonna do is take some score tape, and I do, you know, the edges. Do the edges as close as you can. Close as you can. And the top. And then I'll do one down the middle. So it's like that. And then I will add glue on here. So once I take these off. And I'll add the glue. So that way it's got permanent stick. So I'll add some glue. It's cold down here, so it's gonna be like not sticking very well. And you can take your finger and just spread it around, and then it's gonna be really sticky. It in. I don't want to touch this with my glue finger. Where's my apron? I should have my apron on so I can wipe my hands. That's okay. So the first one is in, and we'll do the outside so you can see what it's going to look like. Same. You don't have to put glue down if you don't want to. But I want this to last for a few years. And hubby's watching TV if you hear it up there. Okay. So we'll take the same thing. We'll take this off. In. Okay. I don't know if I'm going to add glue on this one, maybe. The reason you do it beforehand is because this hurts my hand really bad. It hurts my thumbs. So I'll put a little bit on here. Put a little bit. And this gonna go right on the front. Just like that. So here's our front. Here's the inside. They don't take long. Okay, now my sides right here. And I did them exactly the same, the inside and the outside. So this will go inside and outside. I'm gonna have to trim it down just a tad, like I said. pocket. And it fits. Do I have to trim down the front? Yep, just a tad. Just a little. Perfect. Okay, and then we'll ink it up. Without dropping it everywhere. Okay. I wasn't sure if I was going to even do this, but I decided to do it for December because I'm going to have like the December daily, a couple of videos of that, you know, when I get my pictures. It'll be once a week for an update. And then I still have my planner video, my budget video, two of those a month. And so per week, we'll just do the, per week, we will do planner. Then there's nothing. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday and Saturday are going to be, one of them will be like the December daily. Oh, I need to put some glue in here before I get rid of that one. And this is just hard to use because it's cold. As long as I have some in here, I'll just do dots. I don't want to open another bottle when that one's full. Okay, this is going to go in here. Like that. There's that one on the inside. I should do all the inside ones and then the outside. Okay, and the reason it's sticking is because I still have tape on the outside of this. This is going to be so cute. Okay, so now let's do the outside. Get some. And this one I shouldn't have to cut down because it was measured correctly. Now the inside, you have to cut down because you have those connectors. You have the connectors. And that one, and it's perfect. So, okay. So I'm going to use score tape. On each side. Each side. Each side. Each side. Down the middle, and you're going to put dots of glue. And I'll show you the glue in a minute. This is the glue I use. I love this glue. Works awesome. I do need to make a thing to put in it, though. Because the minute you stand it up, it all goes back down to the thing, to the bottom. And I don't want it to. So. And then we will, I figured this would be fun for the filler days. Like I was saying, we got Monday is planner week. Any hauls I do will be another day during the week. And then Friday and Saturday is usually a craft or something. Now, I'm still doing the inside of the house. So I got the tour coming up. I got to write it all down. Anyway, it's going to be full up this month for you guys. So that's what I'm trying to do. And that's what I haven't got done yet is the calendar. And I need to get the calendar done. Okay, so now we're gonna do the other side. This is what I chose for the outside, right here, is the holly leaves. This is so cute, Santa, the holly leaves, the snowflakes, and then in the back is big snowflakes, is big ones. So I thought that would be fun how it looks. So that's what we're gonna, I could have done like this here and then the opposite on the inside, you know? So I could do this on the outside and, you know what I mean? I could have turned them around, but I'm not gonna. So this one goes inside. Okay, so let's do the inside. Up here, ring. This is a pretty cool project. I think it's gorgeous. I fell in love with it. Certain things have to, I mean, there's a lot of good things out there, but for me to recreate it, I have to really, really, really like it. And I really, really, really like this one. It's ripped off, so we'll just put it on there. Add dots of glue in these spots. So, dots of glue. And then we'll take this off. That off. Looking at this now, and I'm thinking I'm going to do Thursday. This is going to be Friday. You'll see this on a Friday. You'll see this a Friday. And then I'll figure out the next one I do will be Saturday. And maybe I'll do, like, on the weekend, I will do, oops, I didn't, it's too late now. I didn't block that out. And I didn't trim it. Whoops. Let's see if I can cut it. I don't know if I'll be able to. I'll try. I could use my X-Acto knife. Just make sure I do the outside right. And I think I might go around the edge here with something so it looks more finalized. So I may end up doing that. So that's why I should like do this before I even just stamp everything. One will go right here. I mean, it took me a couple of years to get everything together for this, but you know, I didn't do it all at once. I didn't know what I was going to use for paper. I didn't have paper. I was just going to use what I have, and then I didn't have good paper. So, and I bought these 6x6 pads probably the last 2 years or something like that. So I've had them for a little bit. So let's loosen it up a little bit. Just as long as there's a little bit of glue on here so it doesn't come off. It'll hold it. It's just a double protection. I don't know how much wear and tear this will have. Probably not very many. And maybe I will put a couple of pages in it, like my October one I'm doing is more of a thing that goes on the desk. And I thought I was going to do a Christmas one like that too. And then I remembered I had this. So I don't know. There may be another next year, maybe a different little how-to thing. Okay. So now let's put this on. Once it's on, it's on. It's not coming on. But maybe I'll put a piece of felt right here so it doesn't scoot across the floor. Okay. So there's the front, the sides, and now we got the last one is, I didn't do the bottom in here. So I need to cut a piece to fit in here. So I need to cut another one of these, I think. This size. Yep. So let's get a piece of paper and cut. Maybe we should do red down there. I think I don't think this will fit. Let's find a piece that might fit. This polka dot one's cute. This says, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner, and Blitzen. So maybe we'll put that down on the bottom. We will cut this to fit. Because I don't like the back side of it. So let's cut this to fit. And this came from this collection right here. So you can see that. And then we can put this down here. Okay, we need, oops, got it down there, now I can't get it out. Whoops. We need to trim the side a little bit. Glue it in here if I don't want to. Oh, ink first. Okay. And let's put the tape on. I'm not going to put glue on this one, I don't think. Because it's not really gonna. I don't know. We'll see. You know, might as well. Because I've been doing it all along. Okay. My thing is coming apart. It's been irritating me. Okay. Put some glue. Hubby usually gets me a score tape for Christmas. I don't think I put it down this year. He didn't really ask me. He tends to get what he wants from me. But where I craft any kind of like scissors or score tape or anything like that, make sure I put it in here the right way. This is the front. So we want to put it on the front. And I use the extra pieces from cutting to make the sides. That way, like on the bottom, you can see around it and it's not gonna be a big deal. It's gonna be cute. Okay, there's the bottom. We did the bottom. Sides, front, bottom. I'm gonna put felt over here. And I think I have a piece of, what did I do with it? I have a piece of red felt. I'll go over there and look for it in a minute. Let's just get this done. Okay, so now we have the inside, which we're gonna have to turn down just a tad to fit in here. I'm taking like slivers off, so I'm not ruining my, see, and I still need to take a little bit off. I don't think it's cutting correctly. That's better. Okay. Let's do the inside. Do the inside. This is going to be so cute. And then after you're done with the outside, you can decorate it. You know, I'm going to add like snowflakes and maybe some words and all that kind of stuff. You know, you can decorate the outside. Like I said, I might put a border around the bottom of it, and I think I'm going to do something on the top sides here, but you can do all that later, you know, you can do all that after you get it all put together and decide what you want to do, because I have all that extra stuff in there. That's why I put everything, I do this all the time, it's how I craft. I get an idea, and then I get all the supplies that I have in a box. I just find a box and put it in a box. And then I've got stuff all over the place in boxes. And that's how you know. I almost did it again, guys. I almost did it again. I just put it together, and then that way, when I have everything, I can go through it, just pick up the box, and there we go. We are ready. I'm not sure if this is the right way or not. I don't think it really matters, because it's all cut. Yeah, that's okay. There's the back, and this makes it, like, way sturdy, doing this. And then when I put this back one on, it's even going to make it even more so. Get rid of the papers. Okay, which way does this go? Is that good? Yep. Okay, we'll ink it first. Like I said, if you don't ink first, you forget. And I should have just inked all the pieces. But then if you have to cut it, you have to re-ink it anyway. So, it doesn't matter. Okay, this is the last one for this video. We're almost done. We can see what it looks like. And I didn't pause it and come back and pause it and come back because I thought it would be fun. And you can do it along with me or whatever. And you can chit-chat, even though I'm doing all the chit-chat. And middle, add some glue, and it's really not that much glue, it's just barely coming out, but it's making it so it's, so you can see the black side of this paper, on back side of this paper is black, because I thought I was going to do a farmhouse theme, and I haven't. So now if I decide to do that, I need to get paper again because I'm using it all. I'm using like all the reds and greens and stuff out of it. You'll get it all over your hands. All right, there's our box, guys. It's all, it's up the bottom. I'm gonna go get a piece of red felt. Let me see if I have it over here. Pretty sure I do, because I bought it for the gingerbread people that we made. What I was looking for, but it'll work. Here's another project that we're gonna do. Okay, I have this green, so I can't find the red, so maybe we'll just use the green and we will cut out a piece for underneath. We'll mark this with a pen. And cut it out. And put this on the bottom. So, put this on the bottom. This one, we are going to do it the opposite way. We're going to put stuff down here. And if you want to, you can, after you do this, they've got some really cute little legs that you can put for it to stand. And I will probably do that. But I gotta find, I thought I had some of that kind of stuff here, but I don't know. So we'll just put glue on, just like we did the paper. Because if you don't like it, you could always rip it off, you know. But I don't think I'll ever do that. I don't know why I'm using my nails. I have a poker thing. The top. Now I want to trim a little bit of this off. It's overflowing. It is overflowing. There. all done. Our box is all done. All the sides, and it's way sturdy. This is way sturdy now. Like I said, you can get little legs, and see, I can still glue this a little bit right here so it doesn't come up. And you put little legs on here, and it'll stand up. And I've got some pretty like wooden beads that I can paint red or green and put them underneath. It'll be way cute. So there we go. And then we have our, let me take the papers out. These are the papers. Okay. And then we'll put the cards in here. And this is how it will look. Cute. And we'll decorate each page. That's what I thought I would do, is I'm going to cover them all, and then we can decorate after the fact. So, like I said, I don't know how often this will go up, but I want to get it done for December. I think that would be so fun. Then it'll be done, and it'll just sit on my desk like this, even without Christmas. I can sit here and kind of, you know, look at it. Sit here and look at it. So I've got to figure out what I want for page one all the way through. So there we go. There is our thing. And I think I am going to use these numbers because they match the red. So I'm pretty sure I'm going to use these numbers. So I got to figure it out, and because I really want the swirlies on the top. So maybe I can do something with the extra pieces like this and put decorated on the top, so each top will be different. I don't know, it'll be fun. Anyways, all right guys, that is it for now. And I will see how it goes with this. I gotta figure out my video situation and how we're gonna do it. I gotta print out my Christmas calendar. I gotta take this upstairs with me. Here's my little notes. So I will take that with me upstairs. Okay, there is everything all cleaned up. And here you go. Here's what it looks like. So go check that out and see if you wanna do one. And if you feel, I mean, I'm not an expert, but I can measure, I can do that kind of stuff. And, you know, it wasn't the hardest part for me to do, was put the box together, get the measurements right so they're even. That was the hardest thing. But it's so cute. This is a different thing we'll talk about in another video. Alrighty, I will see y'all again soon. Bye now.